Hello and welcome. This is my wife, Mary, and I'm Ed, and we are Branch Davidian Seventh-day Adventists. We're excited you're joining us today. We present or expound on a principle or belief related to the SDA Sabbath School Quarterly each week. The Sabbath School lesson for the fourth quarter of this year is studying Ezra and Nehemiah. This week's lesson is entitled Making Sense of History, Zerubbabel and Ezra, and we are going to try to help with that study today. The Sabbath School lesson gives a chronology of events that led to the rebuilding of the temple in Jerusalem after the Babylonians destroyed Solomon's temple, the first temple. This period is called the Second Temple Period of ancient Israel's history. Today we are going to discuss the types and anti-types associated with these two temples, which will reveal some interesting prophetic truths to us today.
First of all, most of us know about the phenomenon of prophetic type and anti-type, where the type found in the past foreshadows the truth of the anti-type sometime in the future. Ellen White said, "Impressive symbols were employed to unfold the plan of God. Those who desired to look into these things might understand them. This system is not to be passed over in our study of the revelation of truth. From the time when the promise was made in Eden, Christ was shadowed forth in types and symbols. The light gradually increased, becoming more and more distinct until the fullness of the time came."
So here she tells us not to pass over impressive symbols that unfold the plan of truth and our study of the revelation of truth in our day.
Ellen White often mentioned the correlations in type and anti-type concerning ancient Israel and the Seventh-day Adventist Church. She many times referred to the SDA Church, for example, as the Israel of God in these last days. She said, "The same injunctions that rested upon ancient Israel rest upon God's people now. The experience of Christians in these days is much like the travels of ancient Israel."
Okay, I'm sure we all get the point. Today, we are going to show that there is a truth to be revealed in our day in the building of the Second Temple in the days of Ezra and Nehemiah.
The first temple of ancient Israel, usually called Solomon's Temple, prefigured the Church of God at the first advent of Christ in the time of the apostles.
Let's see this in Scripture. 1 Kings 6:7 reads, "And the house, when it was in building, was built of stones made ready before it was brought thither, so that there was neither hammer nor axe nor any tool of iron heard in the house while it was in building." And we can see from Psalm 118:22-23 that the cornerstone initially selected for Solomon's temple was rejected by its builders. It reads, "The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes."
Of course, we can see from 1 Peter 2:4-9 that these stones used to build Solomon's temple represent the people of God's church, and the cornerstone that was chosen by God but rejected by the builders was Christ. It reads, "As you come to him, the living stone, rejected by humans but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, 'See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. Now to you who believe, this stone is precious. But to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that causes people to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the message, which is also what they were destined for. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light."
So it is easy to see that the stone rejected by the builders typified and prophesied the rejection of Christ at his first coming. The first temple, therefore, is a type for the first century church.
And just like the first temple was destroyed by ancient Babylon, the type, the first century church and their teachings were destroyed by, yes, the antitypical Babylon, papal Rome.
So now let's take a look at the second temple and see what it prophesies and typifies. To do that, we should look at the prophets that were prophesying at the time of the building of the Second Temple, namely Zechariah and Haggai.
Yes, the first thing to notice is that both of these prophets not only speak of the rebuilding of the temple and Jerusalem, but they speak of the end times as well, showing us that the perfect fulfillment of their Second Temple prophecies are to be realized in the last days of this world's history. That would be now. For example, in Zechariah 1, we read, "O Lord of hosts, how long will you not have mercy on Jerusalem and on the cities of Judah, against which you were angry these 70 years? the years of captivity in Babylon. Thus says the Lord of hosts, I am zealous for Jerusalem and for Zion with great zeal. I am exceedingly angry with the nations at ease, for I was a little angry, and they helped, but with evil intent. Therefore, thus says the Lord, I am returning to Jerusalem with mercy. My house shall be built in it, says the Lord of hosts, and a surveyor's line shall be stretched out over Jerusalem. Again proclaim, saying, thus says the Lord of hosts, my city shall again spread out through prosperity. The Lord will again comfort Zion and will again choose Jerusalem.
So here we can see that there is a prophecy concerning the rebuilding of the second temple in Jerusalem. But we know from history that although the second temple was rebuilt, the second temple period, prophecies concerning Zion and Jerusalem never fully materialized in their promised glory. As you know, this temple was destroyed in 70 AD. The second temple is a type or a shadow of the Church of God in the end of days. It is a typology of the Seventh-day Adventist movement and the promised glory that will be fulfilled at its purification.
Zechariah prophesies about the coming fulfillment in the last days. The Lord says through Zechariah, behold, the man whose name is the branch, and he shall grow up out of his place, and he shall build the temple of the Lord. Even he shall build the temple of the Lord, and he shall bear the glory, and shall sit and rule upon his throne, and he shall be a priest upon his throne, and the council of peace shall be between them both. And they that are afar off shall come and build in the temple of the Lord, and ye shall know that the Lord of hosts hath sent me to you.
Clearly, this cannot be a prophecy concerning the temple that was built during the Persian period of Israel's history, for Jesus predicted its destruction. It must refer to the end-time church. This is also evidenced by the fact that in the book of Revelation, Jesus himself prophetically points to this prophecy as having a future fulfillment. In Revelation 3:12, Jesus tells us about a temple he is constructing. The people who overcome are going to be used in this construction.
Revelation 3:12 reads, he who overcomes, I will make him a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go out no more. I will write on him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, the New Jerusalem, which comes down out of heaven from my God, and I will write on him my new name.
So here we can see that Jesus is making another temple composed of overcomers. It is the antitype of the second temple of ancient Israel. So the first temple was typical of the first century church. The stones of the first temple typified the first century Christians, and the rejected cornerstone typified the rejection of Jesus Christ by the Israel of the first century.
Now the second temple typifies the end time church. The overcomers are typified by the pillars. Zechariah also prophesies concerning another special stone. Zechariah 3:8-9 reads, hear, O Joshua, the high priest, you and your companions who sit before you, for they are a wondrous sign. For behold, I am bringing forth my servant, the branch. For behold, the stone that I have laid before Joshua, upon the stone are seven eyes. Behold, I will engrave its inscription, says the Lord of hosts, and I will remove the iniquity of that land in one day.
So here we can see Joshua, the type for the antitypical high priest, and God's servant, the branch, who typifies the glorified Christ. There is a stone before typical Joshua, which has seven eyes representing the perfect judgment of Christ. He sees everything perfectly. God tells us he will remove the iniquity of antitypical Israel in one day. That's a prophecy of the purification of the Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Notice Jesus' new name as prophesied in Revelation and Zechariah. It is the branch. In addition to Revelation 3:12, Revelation 2:17 also prophesies about the stone with a new name written on it. The one identified in Zechariah as the builder of this antitypical temple, the end-time church, is God's servant, the branch.
So in review, this stone with seven eyes is none other than God's servant, the branch, which is Jesus' new name spoken of in Revelation 2:17 and 3:12. Jesus, the branch, is the one who builds this new antitypical second temple.
Interestingly, concerning the 144,000, which are the first fruits of this antitypical temple, God's end time church, Ellen White said, the 144,000 were all sealed and perfectly united. On their foreheads was written God, New Jerusalem, and a glorious star containing Jesus' new name.
So here we can see that the 144,000 know and understand Jesus' new name, which Zechariah and Revelation connect to reveal is the branch.
Well, in the Revelation, all the books of the Bible meet and end. Haggai also writes concerning this typology. The Lord, through Haggai, asked the people who were working on the second temple's construction, Who is left among you that saw this house, Solomon's temple, in her first glory? And how do you see it now? Is it not in your eyes in comparison of it as nothing? The glory of this latter house shall be greater than the former, saith the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, saith the Lord of hosts.
Since both temples cannot typify the same period of the Christian era, one temple's glory must typify the first century church, and the second temple's glory must typify the end time church, which we can see will even surpass that of the glorious first century church.
Ellen White said, "The prophets of God spoke less for their own time than for the ages to come, and especially for the generation that would live amid the last scenes of this earth's history."
Well, there is so much more to this typology, but this is all we have time for today. For the present truth concerning this, visit our website or get in touch with us. Thank you for staying with us through the entire video. We invite you to visit our website, www.bdsda.com, to learn more about who we are and, just as important, who we are not. Please join us each week as we will continue to offer new and interesting insights for your Sabbath School studies. God bless.
Many blessings.